Congratulations, I am a... What is the word?
Amazed?
Flabbergasted and delighted. We should celebrate your success, Miss Marcher. Have you ever been to the Broadway Gardens?
Are you asking me to dinner, Professor?
No, yes.
I'd love to.
Oh, but this telegram came for you. Morgan Dews, I suspect, are cooking.
I will. Today I set a revolution.
I can't.
Is it not good news?
Dear God, no. My sister Beth has contracted scarlet fever. I must go to her immediately. Thank you for everything.
Miss March, I would like to accompany you.
Accompany me?
You should not travel alone.
I traveled here alone. I should be fine, but thank you.
Miss March, you will be back.
Of course I will.
And Miss March, you look.
Thanks, I need good luck.
Where is that dreadful little Miss Marshgrove?
Thank you, Mrs. Lawrence. I'll treasure it. I'm so happy to be here with you. Promise me, whatever's got a hold of you, continue to find me. I'll go write a letter to Father. How beautiful Cape Town is this time of year.
Oh, it's amazing. I'm going to take you there.
New York?
Yeah. We'll dine at an amazing restaurant and see Shakespeare.
Joe, I have something for you. Marty says the shell is over 1,000 years old. And I believe that once upon a time it had an amazing life. And if you put it to your ear,
what does it say?
It says, we grow up too fast. You're a woman of the world now, Joe. I'm so proud of you.
When you were first born, not an hour old, I told Larmy.
Beth is mine.
Everyone has someone special in the world. And I have you, my sweet Beth. Give me a task to do.
Let's pretend we're riding on a kite. Let's imagine.
We'll soar.
Let's be one.
two more frogs.
That's almost everything.
Rita, I didn't realize you were coming back too.
Yes, well, we all sailed on the same ship.
You look different.
Do I? Well, I'm taller, an inch or so. I was devastated when I heard the news. I was going to come and see you in New York. I wanted to. Well, I should have, but...
No. I was awful to you, Laurie. I was so unfeeling.
You just said how you felt.
No. Guess what?
What?
I saw a story.
I knew you would. I've always had that kind of faith in you, Joe March.
I know you did. I've missed you.
I've missed you, too. I've decided to go into Grandfather's business. It's the last thing I ever thought I'd be doing for myself, but... If I'm honest, I'm fascinated with the prospects. I shall be wily and shrewd.
Laurie, they are.
Have you told Joe the news?
Tell me what?
Laurie, help me with the rest of my things.
She packs half of Europe.
Laurie, welcome to the family.
I never meant for it to happen like this. I always thought as long as yours.
You've never been my sister, one of us.
I bought you this. It's a book of all my drawings. I do everything you should have seen. All the places, the mountains.
Run up there, bolt the door, and come down hours later, so full of life. I've not seen that Joe in a while.
I can't write. I can't do anything, really. I was always so good at that. Beth would say Joe could make the clouds disappear. I want Beth back. If I'd have never broken my promise and never gone to New York,
Joe,
everything would have been different.
Anymore for Beth. You couldn't have changed what happened.
How do you go on day in, day out as though nothing has happened?
You think that's how I go on?
I want to be like you. You're strong and wise. How can I find the strength?
I should visit. Well, I am here. Here I am. Should I go?
No.
I am not intruding.
You're not intruding. Come inside. I'll introduce you.
No, wait.
How are you?
Oh, older. Nearly 50.
You're not old. You're
34.
35. You had a birthday?
Yes, they threw a party for me. I get sick. I do not like parties. I brought back your manuscript. It's so very thoughtful of you to bring.
Thank you, Professor. There's no one whose opinion I respect more than yours.
Oh, it touched me very deeply. I saw you on every page. I heard your voice. It was magnificent.
You often think about you. I wondered how you were doing.
I bought a kite.
You bought a kite?
Yes, a kite. I flew it in the park. You're right to think I was old. I was old.
No, I...
Yes, even my students. Since I met you, things changed. If my students say, Professor Bear, you are smiling today. Miss March.
Joe.
May I be blunt?
Be blunt, by all means.
When people discover passion, they come across something rare. This fervor they have in common can shelter them anywhere. Though the rest may be rough, with such passion to share, I think they have more than enough. I don't mean today or tomorrow. A week, 2 weeks, a year. I'm a patient man.
I won't be sweet, won't be demure.
This I prefer, this I adore.
I'll speak my mind, you can be sure.
I'll be enchanted to the core.
If I say, let me share a small umbrella,
I'll say, who cares if
we'll be as different as a husband and a wife.
No. We'll be as different as a woman and a man.
We'll fight our way through life.
We'll disagree the best we can.
And yet, you make me smile, you make me laugh, you make me care. How can I explain inside my heart I feel a pain when you're not there? No, we are not at all alike. You make me feel alive. Yes, we have that in common.
Such a fun small thing in common.
Our love is like a small umbrella in the rain.
Ask you again to leave the theatre while we set up for the last show of the night. Thank you very much.